हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन यूनिवर्सिटी। वेलकम टू द फोर्थ मॉक टेस्ट फॉर द एनटीए यूजीसी नेट एंड सेट एग्जामिनेशन पेपर वन ऑफ टीचिंग एप्टीट्यूड। सो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी फॉर द रिस्पॉन्सेज विच यू हैव गिवन टू द अर्लियर मॉक टेस्ट एंड एज प्रॉमिस्ड आई विल बी मेकिंग 20 मॉक टेस्ट बिफोर द जून एग्जामिनेशन। यू कैन वॉच द अर्लियर मॉक टेस्ट, लिंक फॉर दैट इज गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। एंड इफ यू आर वॉचिंग दिस मॉक टेस्ट और वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो ऑन आवर चैनल फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू ग्लोबल ऑनलाइन यूनिवर्सिटी। So friends, this mock test is a little bit hard, and like some of you commented that earlier mock tests were a bit easy, so I have increased the difficulty level bit more, and let me know your score in the comment section. Now we on to the question, why one should give mock test. So mock test on this platform is to assess your preparation. If you are scoring well, then you are going in the right direction, and if you are not scoring good, then you need to give little effort, or some you have to increase your effort to the teaching aptitude paper 1. Now for those who have not studied anything about paper 1, this mock test itself is their preparation, because I am covering 50 questions and I'll be taking 20 mock tests, and from 20 mock tests you will be having the bank of 1000 important questions, and that will be enough for you to answer good number of questions in your examination. So you should give this mock test, and if possible please comment your marks in the comment section. And friends, for other online resources like study material and online mentoring or mock test on our website, you can visit our website Global Online University. The link for that is given in the description. Rules are simple. Pause the video when question appears on your screen. Try to answer. I'll be answering the question there itself. And I have every question carries 2 marks, and there are 50 questions, so exam is of 100 marks. And if you are scoring 80 and above, you are outstanding. You don't have to study your teaching aptitude paper anymore. You just have to revise it, and you have to focus more on your the subject paper. If your score is 60, you need it is okay, but you need some little attention. But if you are scoring 40, you need to give some extra attention to the teaching aptitude paper 1. So moving on to the first question of the day. The question is, government agency responsible for collection of various types of data in India is CSO. So friends, CSO stands for, the options are A, Central Statistical Organization, B, Central Statistics Office, and Central Staff Organization, D, Central Staff Office. So friends, CSO, as you know, that many data they release, like the very recently released employment data, the full form of the CSO is B, Central Statistics Office. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, NPTEL project funded by MHRD stands for. So friends, the NPTEL is a joint initiative between MHRD and IITs, where you will have the online lecture by IIT faculties available on the online platform, and everybody in India can watch them. So the full form for NPTEL is, the correct answer is National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, find out the next term in the following series. So friends, I have also included the mathematical reasoning questions in this mock test, so you will have more such questions. Now coming to this question, where the number series is 0, 3, 8, 15, 24. So this is a simple question to begin with. If you just take out the differences between the adjacent number, so it is in the 0 and 3 it is 3, and from 3 to 8 it is 5, and from 8 to 15 it is 7, and from 15 to 24 it is 9. Now the next number difference should be 11, so if you add 11 to 24 it will be a 35. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is from the environmental section. Which plant is used in biodiesel? So friends, if you have studied or if you know, then only you will be able to answer this question. And the correct answer for this question is Jatropha. So Jatropha is used for the biodiesel making. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Next question is, which of the following will not come under natural hazard? So friends, this is a simple question. If you are able to answer, If you read the question carefully, which of the following does not come under the natural hazard? So if you see, flood is a natural hazard, volcanic eruption is a natural hazard, earthquake is natural hazard, and as you know, the plane crash, it can be a technical or it can be a human error or it can be anything, but it won't come under the natural hazard. So the correct answer here is plane crash. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of NEET, an examination for admission into medical courses in India? So friends, generally this is very common term, but many of us don't know the exact full form of the NEET. Now the options are National Employment Cum Entrance Test, the National Eligibility and Exam Test, the National Entrance and Eligibility Test. Option D is the National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So friends, the correct answer for the long form of the NEET is National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So remember this, though this is very common, but generally we are not aware of it. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, lead tetraethyl is added to gasoline to make. So friends, this is also from the environmental section, and options are to make gasoline thin, to increase its speed, to decrease the fumes. So friends, the correct answer is it is added to gasoline because of its anti-knock property. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Ray Tomlinson introduced this symbol. So friends, this is important personality in the field of information and communication technology, where he has introduced the symbol at the rate. He is a computer programmer, died recently in 2016, and he introduced this symbol at the rate. Generally we use it for email and giving the various type of addresses. So I hope you have answered this correctly. So at the rate symbol was introduced by Ray Tomlinson. So you may be asked who introduced this symbol, other way, like they may also ask you the name of the programmer. So remember this name and the symbol, Ray Tomlinson has introduced the at the rate symbol. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following is unique numeric identifier used to specify particular host computer? Now friends, they have asked you the numeric identifier. So friends, as you know, any particular on the host on network can be identified with IP address. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, HTML stands for. So friends, HTML, the options are hypertext markup language, hypertext marketing language, and hypertext marked language, and D is hypertext markup language. So the correct answer for this question is hypertext markup language, that is option D. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, the content of communication is called. The options are A, message, B, noise, C, channel, D, distortion. So friends, correct answer for this question is, the content of communication is called message. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, who is better teacher? Options are, the one who strictly follows the disciplinary guidelines, the one who devotes full time to school, and the one who is interested in overall development of his students. And option D is one who develops quality leadership in students. So friends, the correct answer for this question is the one who is interested in overall development of the students. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The next question is, students who keeps on asking questions in the class, he should be advised to meet teachers personally. Option B, should be encouraged to participate in classroom discussion. Option C, should be encouraged for self-learning. Option D, should be encouraged for continue questioning. So friends, here correct answer is should be encouraged for continue questioning, because questioning while learning is a good habit, and it will like if you stop that habit, then it will be like killing the curiosity of the student. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, identify the unethical practice of the researchers from the following. So these questions are from research aptitude. So the unethical practice is, see, options are avoiding plagiarism. So you should avoid plagiarism. This is ethical practice. B, avoiding duplication. This is also a ethical practice. You should avoid duplication. And avoiding manipulation, option D is also an ethical practice. You should avoid manipulation. So the unethical practice here is avoiding the reliable data, avoiding the reliable information is an unethical practice. So friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. The answer is C, avoiding reliable information is an unethical practice. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, effective learning means, so options are modification in behaviors of learner, B, consistency in behavior of learner, C, to recall information by the learner, and C, D is good performance of the learner in the examination. So friends, the correct answer for this question is modification in the behavior of the learner. So the effective learning means modification in the behavior of the learner. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, basic purpose of the communication is. So friends, if you have studied is the basic purpose, there are five purposes of the basic purposes of the communication, and the main purpose of the communication is to inform, to pass the message. So the correct answer is option A, to inform. The basic purpose of the communication is to inform. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, person who transmits a message is called. So friends, this question is from the communication section. So so the options are A, receiver, B, sender, C, decoder, D, barrier. So the correct answer, the person who transmit a message is called sender. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is required while reading? The options are A, ability to comprehend, B, reasons for reading, C, help in reading, and D, time for reading. So friends, these all the options looks correct, but the correct and the most probable answer for this question is ability to comprehend. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, one number in the following number series is wrong, find out that number. So friends, if you this is a question from the number series, and if you look at these numbers, like if you try to subtract, or if you try to add, or if you try to do multiplication, you will not be able to get the correct answer. If you know the squares of the numbers, then you will understand that the 196 is the square of 14, and 169 is of 13, 144 is of 12, and 121 is of 11. But 101 is not a square of 10, so it should have been 100 in this series. So the correct answer here is 101. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, the 1 terabyte is equal to. So friends, I have covered lot of questions regarding this memory conversion, so you should be able to answer this. Options are 8 GB, B, 18 GB, C, 10 24 GB, and D, 30 GB. So 1 terabyte is equal to 1024 GB, 1024 gigabyte. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, pointing towards a person, a man said to a woman, his mother is the only daughter of your father. So friends, how is this woman related to that person? I suggest you read this question carefully and try to answer. The options are daughter, B, sister, C, mother, and D, wife. So for this question, this type of question, you need to have practice. So the correct answer for this question is mother. The woman is mother of the said person. I hope you have answered this correctly. If not, you can practice, and if you still have doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Konkani is related to Goa in the same context Dogri is related to. options are. So friends, Konkani is a language, or is a language spoken by the region from the Goa and the Konkan region. And in the same way, Dogri is a language and it is spoken in which region? So options are A, Andhra Pradesh, B, Maharashtra, C, Himachal Pradesh, and D, Assam. So friends, correct answer for this question is, it is spoken in Himachal Pradesh region. So Dogri is a language spoken in Jammu Kashmir, some part of Punjab, and the part of Himachal Pradesh. So remember this. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is web browser? So friends, if you see the options, the option A is Windows. So Windows is a operating system, Linux is the operating system, iOS is the operating system for Apple. And the correct answer for this question is option C, that is Google Chrome. It is a web browser. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Rousseau advocated an educational method which consisted of removing the child from. So if you know the biography of Rousseau, you'll be able to understand this. So Rousseau advocated an educational method which consisted of removing the child from option A, school, option B, burden, option C, past memory, option D, society. So correct answer for this question is Rousseau. When it comes to Rousseau, you remember burden. So he advocated removing the burden from the educational method which consisted of removing the child from the burden. Now moving on to the next question. All who have meditated on the art of governing mankind have been convinced that the fate of empires depend on the education of youth. So this statement, like whose this statement is? So options are A, Aristotle, Socrates, Plato, and John Locke. So the correct answer, this statement is made by the Aristotle. So I hope you have guessed it correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, communication by using the eyes is an example of. So options are A, non-verbal communication, B, written communication, C, verbal communication, D, none of the above. Friends, the communication by using eye or by hand gestures or by other means, it is non-verbal communication. So it comes under the non-verbal communication. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in a group discussion, we should be. So friends, options are, so A, assertive, B, dominating, C, subjective, and D, ignorant. So D can be easily ignored here, because one can't be ignorant while discussing. So the correct answer is, you should be confident and you should put your point with confidence. So the correct answer is assertive. In a group discussion, we should be assertive. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, in one-way communication, a message are passed without. So in one-way communication, message are passed without A, receiver, B, channel, C, treatment, and D, feedback. So friends, in one-way communication, one doesn't care about the feedback or the responses from the receiver. So correct answer here is the feedback. So when there is no feedback, it is one-way communication. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is about the number series, and in this series, so here friends, it is 3, 11, 23, 39, and 59. So what will be the next number? So friend, if you subtract 11 from 3, it will be 8 from the first, and if you subtract 23 from 11, it will be 12, and if you subtract 39 from 23, it will be 16. So it is from the 8 12. So the difference is coming 8 12 16, then 24. So that way, if you finally, if you come across, the correct answer will be 73. If you add 24 to 59, it will be 73. I hope you have answered this correctly. And in this question, if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment. You can just write the question number, and if there is any doubt, you can or if there is any query, you can or any suggestion, you can bring to my notice. Okay, moving on to the next question. Next question is, in an effective communication, there is no need of. So friends, in an effective communication, option A is modulation in voice and speech, B adequate gestures, mastery over the content. So these top three are important for effective communication. So handsome personality, like there is no need of handsome personality for the effective communication. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of these is important in having mutual understanding with your colleagues? So friends, options are A effective listening, B speaking, C talking, and D writing. So friends, listening to others, that way if you are not listening to anyone, then there will be no understanding. So the correct answer for this question, for having a mutual understanding with your colleague, you should be a good listener or effective listener, or you should listen to the people. So the correct answer is effective listening. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, in a group discussion, one must communicate with. So friends, one cannot communicate with hostility, that my point is only valid, or I'm only the correct person. B ignorance, we have also discussed in the earlier question, it is also ruled out. And long sentences, so you should, it should also be eliminated, because you should put your point in precise manner in shortest possible sentences. Now the correct answer here is, in group discussion, one must communicate with knowledge. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, full form of BOD. So this question is from people and environment section. So friends, BOD is a I hope you know this. I'll read the options, and maybe meanwhile you can get your answer. Biodegradable oxygen demand, biological oxygen demand, biochemical oxygen demand, and Bradwick sound demand. So the correct answer for this question is biochemical oxygen demand. So read, this is very important topic in term in with respect to environment, biochemical oxygen demand. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is appropriate definition of a computer? So friends, they have asked us the appropriate definition of the computer. So a computer is a machine that can process information. So that this is correct, but it is not a precise definition. Now moving on to the next question is, computer is an electronic device that can store, retrieve, and process both qualitative and quantitative data quickly and accurately. So this looks the correct definition, but we'll see other options and then come back. Computer is an electronic device that can store, retrieve, and quickly process only quantitative data. So this is wrong. Computer, option D is, computer is a machine that can store, retrieve, and process quickly and accurately only qualitative data. So C and D is eliminated, and in from option A and B, B looks the correct answer, because it is precise definition. Now I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which one of the following is not a source of data? Options are A administrative records, B population census, C GIS, and D sample survey. So friends, if you look at option A, administrative records are source of data, population census also give us data, and sample survey gives the data. But geographic information system is not a source of data, it is a framework of gathering, managing, and processing the data. So correct answer is here is GIS. So GIS is not a source of a data. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following comprises of teaching skill? So first is A blackboard writing, B questioning, C explaining, and D all of the above. If you look at the options, so all of these, blackboard writing, questioning, and explaining, comes under the teaching skills. So here the correct answer is all of the above. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Which is numbers system used to store data and for the calculation in the computer? So this is from the ICT, Information and Communication Technology, and the options are A, decimal system, B, hexadecimal system, C, octal system, and D, binary system. So question is, which number system is used for storing data and calculation in the computer? So friends, the correct answer is, it is a binary number system. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is pointing device? So friends, pointing device is a directing device, means it appears on your computer, like your cursor, your mouse. And same applies. Now the we'll see the option. Option A is hard disk. It is not a pointing device, it is storage device. CD-ROM drive also is a storage device. And RAM also is not a pointing device. So the correct answer is touch screen used for the computer input. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, computer memory consists of. So it is RAM, ROM, CPROM. So the correct answer here is, all these three are the computer memory. I hope you have answered this correctly. So the correct answer is all of the above. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, no computer can do anything without. So they have asked very basic question. So minimum requirement for computer functioning is, say, option is A, program, B, memory, C, chip, and D, output device. So friends, the main thing that that is required for computer to do anything is a program, computer program. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. In comparison to internal, that is main memory, disk memory is. So friends, this is a very important question. I hope you know this disk memory. It is slower and less expensive. So it is slower, but it is less expensive. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, a monitor looks like a TV set, but it does not. So friends, if you look at laptop or say any desktop monitor, it has. So options are, look wise they are same, but what is the difference? A, receive TV signals. They do not receive TV signal. They do not give clear picture. So they both give good picture. If you have good laptop, laptop, it will give good picture. Give steady picture. They both give steady picture. And both can display graphics. So the only difference is, they cannot receive the TV signal. Laptop screen or say desktop screen, they don't receive the TV signal. So that is the difference. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. So next question is, when sending an email, the dashed line describes the content of the message. So it is a title of the message, or you can say the subject line. You know, subject, you write whatever the main content. So that is the describe the content of the message. So correct answer is subject. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, dash is collection of web pages, and dash is the very first page that we see on opening a website. So friends, when you see a like, I will give a general example, like CrickBuzz or say CrickInfo, when it is a website. So it is, but if you look at the different web pages, there will be like a live score, there will be some articles. So different web pages will be there. So what is where here? So website is a collection of different web pages. So now you understood the web pages, and the when you click on the CrickBuzz in or any CrickInfo, I'm just giving a general example of the website. If you click, what you see is a home page. So it is the first page, and once from home page, you can go to the different pages. So the correct answer here is website and home page. Please, if you are not clear with this, you can check it on Google. Like, you can open any website and you see what you go is on the home page, and then if you click on the other pages, that is sub pages, or we call web pages. Now moving on to the next question. Land speeds are measured in. So friends, if you have these days in India, everybody is using Jio, and you have 2 GB, or based on your plan 1 GB limit. After that, your speed. So land speed is measured in Mbps, megabits per second. I hope you have wrote it correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is a URL is. So friends, we have discussed different questions regarding URL. You should be able to answer. These options are a computer program, so it is not a computer program. A type of web server? No, it is an address of a document or page on the World Wide Web. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which law protects the crime through internet? So friends, nowadays a lot of crimes are happening on the internet. So the, and we also see that cyber security team, cyber team of the different states or different cities are working hard to protect the internet, or to keep the watch on the internet related crime. So the cyber laws protect the crimes, or they look after the crimes through internet. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, ATM stands for. So ATM stands for A, option all time money, B, any time money, C, automated teller machine, and D, arithmetic teller machine. So correct answer for ATM is automated teller machine. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. What is the full form of MOOC? So friends, why I have included this question? Because as we have seen earlier, NPTEL is a Indian online learning platform of the top notch IITs and MHRD, and MOOC, it is an international online learning platform from the Harvard and MIT University in collaboration with Microsoft. So the long form for this is massive open online courses. So remember this, what is MOOC? So as I told, it is a online learning platform. It is an initiative of the Harvard, MIT and top notch in universities with Microsoft. So remember, there are a lot of online courses which one can watch all around the world for free. So the long form for the MOOC is massive open online courses. Moving on to the last question of the day. World Environment Day is celebrated on. So this is factual question. If you remember this, the correct answer for World Environment Day is 5th June. So it is celebrated on the 5th June to make people or make public aware of the hazards and the protection of the environment. I hope you have answered. This mock test was good for you. You have scored well. If not, you can also keep on watching our mock test. And friends, if you have liked it, please subscribe to our channel, Global Online University. Thank you. Thank you for watching.